Gordon, it's the eternal debate, AMD versus Intel on the CPU side of things. You know, say we're not going to look at the, you know, high core count Threadrippers and Xeons, and we're going to get a discrete GPU. What do you think is the landscape out there for CPUs? What are the strengths and weaknesses of AMD? What are the strengths and weaknesses of Intel?
Well, first, no matter what you read, no matter what you hear, there is no right answer. There is a right answer for you. So don't let anybody else tell you you made the wrong decision on what you bought. But okay. Right now, I think AMD has the advantage for most people running discrete graphics.
Okay.
First, let's go over why Intel is great, why Intel's fantastic right now. Intel has higher clock speeds.
Yeah.
They generally have slightly better IPCs. They have an infrastructure that has been nailed down longer. There have been Intel boards that have been around a lot longer. So kind of, if you want to consider more stable, right? Yeah. AMD okay. Ryzen motherboards, pretty new. Most 90% of the time, 99% of the time, no problems. But Intel is the rock that they can lean on because it's Intel. It's all the warm fuzziness you get with an Intel product. But the reason why I'm going to say AMD is still better is because it's just so much value, which is you get more cores or more threads, more hardware, because a lot of AMD CPUs, you actually get the cooler inside. Intel doesn't give you the cooler with most of its high-end parts.
Okay.
So you got to factor in buying a cooler, and then there's a price difference. Generally, Intel 9700K, 9700KF that's coming out, the 9900K, 9900KF that's coming out, faster, higher clocks, pricier too.
Oh yeah.
$530 for the highest end part.
If you can get them.
If you can get it, almost $400 for the 9700K versus what you're getting out of AMD. 8 cores, 8 thread, 2700X is 284 with the cooler.
Okay.
Ryzen 5 2600X is 185 with the cooler. You're looking at $200 to $150 more in your pocket with AMD. Now, Intel will give you higher clocks, generally better gaming performance,
yeah,
sometimes better application performance because everybody runs on Intel. They've been optimizing for Intel for a long time, generally faster. I'm willing to give up, say, 20% of frame rate.
Okay.
Generally, that's across the board and in games, older games especially, where it's just CPU limited and not GPU limited, because for the $150 to $200 I will get out of AMD, I could put that toward a fatter GPU.
Mm.
So for a gaming machine, and most of these processors without integrated graphics, let's face it, they're being used for gaming machines. That's the difference between a 2060 and a 2070, practically. Pretty close. $200 will definitely get you from a 2060 to a 2070. $150, a little less, but still you're a lot closer to a 2070. That's a big step up in graphics, and for most games, you're gonna want a fatter GPU rather than a fatter CPU.
True.
That's not to say Intel is got problems. Again, we just said it's faster. You also get QuickSync, as you mentioned, for people who do video editing. QuickSync is a huge difference. It slays CPU-based encoding, and it'll even kick the smoke out of GPU encoding for the most part. It's pretty awesome.
Yeah.
You can only get that on Intel small sockets. For people who are into video, Premiere, those kind of things, might actually be worth it.
Yeah, well, and there's some people out there who've been burned by AMD in the past.
Yeah, know? I mean, yeah, there's some bad blood in the past. AMD CPUs have not been the fastest in the past, but Ryzen is a real deal. It's a real fast CPU. Most applications, it's gonna be very close, somewhat faster than Intel counterpart. Something's a little slower. And in gaming, generally 10, 15% slower, worst case scenario, maybe 20%, depending on the game.
Okay.
If it's a pure GPU limited game, if you're playing Battlefield 5 Ray Trace or Metro Exodus Ray Trace, it's not gonna make that much of a difference.
Yeah.
So I say the advantage goes to AMD. I think for most people, AMD, but if you've got the money, you're not that price sensitive. I am, but if you're not that price sensitive, or you want the absolute best for a mainstream single socket gaming machine, 9900K, 9700K, still got a strong message, but will cost more.
Okay, well, actually, I am very interested to hear what you have to say about this. Why did you decide to pick AMD or Intel, or why are you going to pick one of them? I want to hear what people think, you know, about the landscape as of right now. Like you said earlier, they shouldn't just listen to you, Gordon.
No,
right?
They gotta listen to everybody, right? No, definitely not.
It depends on your use case, so.
It's not the best hardware, it's what's the best hardware for you.
Exactly.
For some people, QuickSync, higher clocks, it's best for them. Costs them more, but it's best for them.
Yeah, right. Okay. Well, thank you, Gordon, for trying to take on this eternal debate for me. And we will talk to you later.